Oops is the first budget brand that we have found that offers a decent product and some solid customer support. And ever since we got our hands on the Oops Mega 3, we've been recommending Oops as our budget brand that we would recommend to people if they're trying to save a little bit of money but still get a solid unit. But just because they hit a home run the first time does not mean they won't strike out next time they're at bat. So today we have our hands on the little brother, the Oops Mega 2, to find out if the Oops brand is legit. And it's pronounced Opus. We're calling it Oops though. Welcome back to the lab. You guys know here, our opinions cannot be bought. And in Oops's opinion, this Mega 2 unit is superior to all the competitor 2000 watt units from Jackery, Bluetti, EcoFlow. They even made up a nice little chart and threw it on their website to show you how much better it is than the competition. We've been playing with the Mega 2 for a little while now. We ran it through some testing, and we also have just a couple gripes with this unit that we would like to share with you guys. We'll also share a couple of things that we do like. And as always, we will leave links and any discount codes that we're able to get from Opus in the description down below to share with you guys. Before we jump into anything else, we're gonna hit you with a super quick spec teardown on the Mega 2 in case you're not already familiar with this guy. First up, this thing weighs 46 pounds, so it does pass the tiny baby lift test, even though they basically weigh the exact same amount. He can still pick this thing up to show off his muscles. It's got a 2,048 watt hour battery bank, and this unit is actually expandable up to 10.24 kilowatt hours. It's got a 2,500 watt pure sine wave inverter with a rated 5,400 watt surge. And in terms of getting power into this guy, you can plug it directly into a 120 volt wall outlet in your house. It'll charge up with 1,600 watts the AC input. You also have a 2100 watt rated solar input, which we will get into later. In terms of ports, you got a 30 amp plug on the front here, as well as 420 volt house outlets. You have two barrel connectors and a 12 volt car socket, and you have a cluster of USB and USB-C ports, as well as one Anderson port for whatever you want to do with Anderson ports. The screen is actually really nice on these guys. The camera hates picking it up. It's always flashing and doing weird stuff on camera, but it's actually really nice in person. This thing also has an app. You can connect to Bluetooth and Wi-Fi. You can actually sync this up with like your Google Home or your Alexa and just tell it to turn stuff on and off, which is kind of cool. And you can get this unit for $12.99. Technically it's $14.99, but it's on like a permanent $12.99 sale. Even the chart they have on their website says $12.99. So that's the price that we're rolling with. We're gonna get started with the Mega 2, talking about things that we just don't like about this unit. And first up is the 30 amp plug. I love 30 amp plugs. It's also in the things we do like. But unfortunately, that this is only a 2,500 watt inverter, so this isn't a true 30 amp plug. You could plug your trailer into this and run some stuff off of it, sure. But you can't actually use 30 amps out of the plug. So I don't love that. I would love to see a 30 amp plug paired up with an inverter that can actually handle the full 30 amps, which would be about 3,600 watts, which is obviously a bit bigger than this unit here, but that's just me nitpicking. It's not a big deal. It's got pros and cons. Second thing that we don't love about the Mega 2 is that the solar input is just hard to achieve. It's rated for 12 to 150 volts and 15 amps. All of our rigid panels are somewhere in the 20 volt range, and they're all just under 10 amps. So you can only do like six 200 watt panels into this, which is only like 1200 watts before you start running into problems. There is some workarounds that we will get into in the testing part of the video, but it's just something that if you have panels already, but a setup already, and you buy this thing, it might be a little bit hard to make everything work with this unit. Most power stations, when you have them on, they don't really consume any energy. If you had it sitting here and you had the AC inverter on, it'll consume energy. You'll see the battery percentage start dropping and dropping and dropping and dropping, even if there's no load, because it's keeping the inverter on and it's consuming power. Like right now at 82%, it says there's 25 hours left, and that's with no load. But something weird with this power station is that even with the inverter off, over the course of a day, if you just leave the actual power station on, you can watch the battery percentage drop a lot quicker than some of these other units. So I'm not entirely sure what it's doing with that power, but it's something to be noted. If you were gonna leave, if you forgot to turn it off or something, you would actually lose more power than we're used to seeing just from having it idle. And the last thing that I don't like about the Mega 2 is that it has no light. You guys know I'm a big light guy. This is almost a 50 pound unit. You're not gonna be carrying it around with one hand. You're gonna be picking it up with two. I had a power outage earlier this year, and I had to pick up a power station like this and carry it upstairs in the dark because it didn't have a light on it. Just throw freaking light on this thing so that when the power's out, I can light up the area around. I can light up where I'm trying to put it, whatever. Put lights on power stations. And that leads us into the testing portion of this video. And we started by testing the efficiency of the Mega 2. This is a 2000 watt hour battery bank. If you had a 1000 watt load running off of this, you would expect it to last for 2 hours. If it was 100% efficient, nothing ever is. And so we ran a 2330-ish watt load off of this guy. So it's just below the 2500 watt inverter limit. So it should be working pretty hard. The fans are running. It's basically at its least efficient point right there. It should have lasted running that load about 53 minutes. It actually lasted just over 44 minutes, which puts this thing at 83% efficiency, just under the inverter limit, which is better than actually a lot of power stations that we talk about. In terms of AC charging, this has a 1600 watt input limit. So it actually charged from the wall in 2 hours and 7 minutes, which is a little bit slow considering the battery bank size, but not terrible. When it comes to surge though, this is a 2500 watt inverter rated for 5400 watts of surge. It does surge, but it's just a quick blip. You could see if I go ahead and turn on like a 3000 watt load, which is 2 1500 watt heat guns, it basically shuts instantly off. It doesn't last at all, which is technically a surge, but a lot of other power stations will actually run more than they're rated for 5, 10, 15 seconds. So if you accidentally pump it, you have a second to turn it off. This won't give you any forgiveness. As soon as you pass the 2500 watt limit, you're done. When it comes to the sound test on this guy, it's actually relatively medium. It sounds kind of like a Delta Pro. It's got like this computery fan noise to it. It's not loud, but it's not quiet. I wouldn't want to sleep beside it, but I'm not mad about it. It's medium. But when it comes to solar input, like we already kind of mentioned, it's weird. First up, it has an Anderson port. Don't do that. let's just get everybody on the same page and start using the XT60s. It has a 12 to 150 volt limit on the Anderson port with a 15 amp max. It's doable to get 2100 watts of solar into this, but you need very specific gear. The only thing that we even have here at the lab that would work is a folding 100 watt anchor panel. They're like 3.7 amps. So you could do like 4 strings of 5 100 watt anchor folding solar panels into this, which is a massive pain in the ass. That's way too many folding panels to run. And even then you're only at 2000 watts and you have 20 folding panels laid out in the yard. So it is doable. It's just a very tight number to reach. I would love to see either a higher amperage limit so you can run bigger panels, but more strings of them, or just a much bigger voltage limit to kind of shove all that power in. We have a panel stand with 2 400 watt panels. They don't even work because the amperage is way too high on them. And then we have another panel stand with 4 200 watt solar panels, and that it alone is almost at the limit of what this thing can do, and that's only 800 watts. So it's just weird. And finally, we tested the pass through. If you have something running off one of these plugs in the front, can you plug it into the wall or plug it into a solar panel, continue to power what you had running, and then put the rest of the power into the batteries? And it does both AC and solar pass through, which is good news. Jumping into some of the things that we like about the Mega 2, I think the thing that I like the most is if you're trying to save some money and you don't want to buy the Mega 3, you don't lose very much functionality going down in size. So you have 4 120 volt plugs on the front of this. You have 5 on the Mega 3, but that's the only difference. You keep, it's basically the same layout. You keep your Anderson port, you keep all your USBs, you keep your 30 amp, you keep your 12 volt, you keep your barrel connectors. You have the same solar input, you have the same AC input. You basically keep the whole thing. It's just a smaller battery and a smaller inverter. So while that hinders you in like the 30 amp situation, it's still kind of nice that you don't lose a ton of shit when you go down. I also like that this is a relatively lightweight unit compared to some of the other ones of its size. It just feels lighter. It just feels like easier to pick up and move around. I really like that. I just also think it's a really good looking unit. When we first saw it, we were not sold, but the Oops design has actually kind of grown on us a lot. It's a lot less bushwhacker than some of the other products that we look at. It's just a clean, kind of like simple, elegant looking unit. And I do like that there's a 30 amp plug. I know I said I don't like that it's not a true 30 amps, which is true. I hate that it isn't a true 30 amp plug, but I do like that if you wanted to bring this into like a trailer or something like that, like an RV, you could plug this in and run light loads off of this. So it would be good for like an emergency backup situation or while you're on the road or something like that. And we also like the expandability of this little unit. A lot of times with smaller units, you can stack one or two, you can add a little bit, but something like this, you could buy one. And then if you decide you need more battery bank, you can buy another expansion battery, and you can get that way more than you can get like a similar EcoFlow or Jackery or whatever competitive unit, which is nice. I know not everybody expands their power stations, but having the ability is really, really key. And Oops's expansion batteries actually do have a couple ports on them. A lot of other things like EcoFlow's expansion batteries don't do anything. Anker's expansion batteries don't do anything except plug into the unit. The Oops ones, you could charge your phone off the battery when it's not even attached, which is just like an extra little bonus feature. And the last two things that we like about Oops as a brand is that for a budget brand, they actually have decent customer support. We've actually called them. We were mystery shopping some companies and we decided to call them and just see what was up. And they actually are like really helpful. They were US based, at least the people that we spoke to when we called the customer support number. And they seemed good. Like a lot of times, some of these like budget brands, they only have a phone number for China and you can't even call it. So the fact that these guys have like a US support is really cool. And we like that Oops has some form of help project. So every time you buy an Oops product, 5% of the sales go towards donating power stations to people in need, which is really cool. They have some photos on their website of people with like oxygen breather things and whatever. That is pretty cool. I like when companies do that because they don't have to. A lot of these companies are out here, billion-dollar publicly traded companies, and they don't help anybody other than themselves. The fact that Oops is doing something above and beyond what they have to, we really like. And they offer that on an actual competitively priced product. At the end of the day, is the Oops Mega 2 better than the EcoFlow, Blue Eddy, Jackery competitive units? That's up for you to decide. We were decently impressed with this one though, as there is a few quirks like there is with anything, but when it comes to like the budget brands, I still think we would recommend Oops. You're getting what you pay for and you don't always get what you pay for. Let me know what you guys think in the comments. Otherwise, that is all we got for you guys. I will catch you in the next one. Thank you so much for watching. Peace out and stay charged.